Have I told you lately that I love you? No, seriously. Have I told you lately that I'm doing a research study on a research medication for an antidepressant? I think it's called Rextoli. And I'm going to pause because my seatbelt beeping is going to go off. No, I don't like to wear my seatbelt. I'll give you two reasons why I don't like wearing my seatbelt. The first reason is that I feel so big and overweight that it's not comfortable to wear it around my stomach anymore. I feel like I'm squeezing sausage into a M&M shell. And the second reason is that I'm short, my torso and my neck and all that. So when I wear my seatbelt, especially in this car, it cuts right here onto my neck and it hurts. So I'm not comfortable driving. And I feel like I'm a better driver without my seatbelt than I am when I'm wearing it. Although if my kids ask me to put my seatbelt on while we're driving, I won't argue with them. I'll just put it on. It makes them feel better, and I like that they're being safe and thinking of their mom, you know, as someone who's respecting them and being safe as well. Anyway, that's besides the point. I know if my videos ever do become public on YouTube for whatever reason, whether I want to share my story with the public or whether, maybe they become beneficial, or maybe I become famous someday for some reason. I know it's going to be frowned upon that I videotape while I drive, but do you see me looking at the camera? Do you see me looking at the phone very often? Hardly and never. I mean, I'm constantly looking at the road. I'm a very cautious driver, and I don't speed, and I am driving with one hand. But a lot of us do, whether we're talking on the phone. This is no different than if I'm talking on the phone. Talking on the phone or drinking while I'm talking, you know, drinking, not drinking alcohol, but drinking like a soda. Well, because everyone drives with one hand sometimes. And I think I do just fine. Now, if I was nervous, I will put down the phone and I won't do it. If I have an anxiety or panic attack or something, I won't do it. I only do it when I feel like I need to talk, and I only do it when I feel safe to do it. And I don't think anybody that understands will argue with me. If you don't understand, then you might, but whatever. This is my life, not yours. So anyways, what am I talking about? Oh, I'm on a research medication. I also have bronchitis right now. It seems to be something I get every year. I gotta figure out how to stop getting that every year. But anyway, my research medication I'm using with Lexapro, which is the original antidepressant that's been out forever, I guess. But the Rextoli, I think that's what it's called, is something I'm using in conjunction with the Lexapro. So let me just show you what it looks like. Just because I'm at a stoplight and I can show you. All right, so these are my pills of the Rextoli. I take one I have two pills that I take a day. One of the things in the big silver pouch, and then one of the little ones. And I have been on this study. This is my fourth week. And I go there every week, except now I'm going to go there every 2 weeks. So I have two packages now. And I'm going to basically try out my... Just basically they want to check my symptoms and see if my depression has improved or if it's worsened or it stayed the same. And there is a time frame where I will be on a placebo. And the placebo will either do nothing for me, or I will think that I'm on it still, and they will. There's a funeral reception, so it's a little distracting. Maybe I'll think that I'm still on medication that will help me, and that, you know, placebos do anyway. Anyway, my phone says I'm going to run out of time here, so I'm going to let you all go. And I'll talk more about this research stuff another time, I guess. Bye-bye.